Hi students, this is Muhammad Kaleem, your mathematics teacher. Welcome to mathematics class. Today we are going to discuss about definition of trigonometric ratios. Before going to start what we discussed in previous class, let us recall. We discussed about relationship between length of the sides and angles of a right angle triangle, and in which we have to discuss about what is the meaning of opposite side and adjacent side and hypotenuse. Let us start.
So this is a right angle triangle. Now in which I am taking here some perpendicular lines. First I will draw this wall, then I will give the name like this. Okay. Draw a horizontal line first on a paper. Let the initial point be A. So this is the initial point. And mark other points B. Mark other points B here. Next, after that C. Next D. Next E, at a distance of 3 centimeters, 6 centimeters, 9 centimeters, 12 centimeters. That means here I am taking here to here. This is 3 centimeters. Next here to here 6 centimeters. Like that. A to D 9 centimeters, A to E 12 centimeters respectively from A. Now draw the perpendiculars BP, CQ, DR and ES of lengths 4 centimeters, 8 centimeters, 12 centimeters, 16 centimeters from the points B, C, D and E. Then join AP, PQ, QR and RS. That means BP is equal to here. I will take here. BP is equal, this is 4 centimeters. This is 8 centimeters. Next, this is 12 centimeters from the points B, C, D and E respectively. Then join AB, next PQ, QR and RS. Find the lengths of AB, AQ, AR and AS by using length of hypotenuse 5 centimeters, 10 centimeters, 15, 20. Length of the opposite side 4 centimeters, 8, 12, 16. Length of the adjacent sides 3, 6, 9 and 12. So here I will show you how should we take that. Here I am taking this like this. Okay. This is A and this is B and this is from the above diagram, from the previous diagram. Now AB we took 3 centimeters and this is 4 centimeters. So we already learned Pythagoras theorem in similar triangles by using that one. Here we have to find AP. So AP is equal to, we know the formula, that means Pythagoras theorem, AB square is equal to AB square plus BP square. We know this one. When we are substituting these values in that, so what is AB? Not given, as it is write down. AB is equal to how much? 3 centimeters, that means 3 square. And what is BP? 4 given, 4 square. So 3 square means how much? 9. Next, 4 square means how much? 16. 9 plus 16, how much? 25. So 25, AP square is equal to 25 means AP is equal to under root of 25, that is equal to 5. So like that, here we are getting length of the hypotenuse as 5. So this is becomes 5. Same like that, when we are taking this is 6, this is 8, we will get 10. 6 square means 36, 8 square means 64. 64 plus 36, 100. 100 square root, 10. Same like that, 9 square. 9 square means 81. 12 square means 144. That is equal to 225. Which is equal to, which is square root is 15. Same as here, 12 square means 144. 16 square means 256. We see this sum is 400. 400 square root is 20. Now here we have to use opposite side by hypotenuse ratio. So what we are getting? 4 by 5. This is opposite side is here 4. Opposite side is 4 and hypotenuse is 5. So 4 by 5. Like this we have to write remaining all. 8 by 10. Next 12 by 15. Next 16 by 20. Same as second one. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is given here 3. So 3 by 5. Next 6 by 10. 9 by 15. 12 by 20. So now then find the ratios of BP by AP, comma CQ by AQ, comma DR by AR and ES by AS. Did you get the same ratios as 4 by 5? Yes, absolutely. We are getting same ratios. So 8 by 10 means nothing but when we are cancellation by 2 table, 2 4s are 8 and 2 5s are 10. So 4 by 5. Same as one more. DR is 12, AR is equal to 15. So 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15. Similarly, we get one more. That is also 4 by 5. 16 by 20 means nothing but 4 by 5. Similarly, try to find the ratios AB by AP. Already we found here in the table. Similarly, we will get here 3 by 5. 6 by 10 also equal to 3 by 5. AD by AR is equal to 3 by 5. AE by AS is equal to 3 by 5. So, what you observe here, ratio always constant. So, hypotenuse by opposite by hypotenuse is equal to 4 by 5. Always we are getting 4 by 5. And adjacent side by hypotenuse also we are getting 3 by 5 in all cases. When we are increasing the length of the hypotenuse as well as length of the adjacent side. But we will get here constant value. So defining trigonometric ratios. In the above activity when we observe right angle triangle ABP, ACQ, ADR and AES, angle A is common. Angle B, angle C, angle D and angle R right angles and angle P, angle Q, angle R and angle S also equal. Hence we can say that these triangles are similar. We already learnt in the similarities of similar triangles in similar triangle chapter. So I think so no need to explain all this. When we are observe the ratio of opposite side of angle A and hypotenuse in a right angle triangle and the ratio of similar sides in another triangle, it is found to be constant. We already proved in the previous table. In the all above right angle triangles ABP, ACQ, ADR and AES and the ratios BP by AP, CQ by AQ, DR by AR and ES by AS also equal to 3 by 5. can be named sin A or simply sin A in those triangles. If the value of angle A is x when it was measured, then the ratio would be sin x. So here, when we are taking in right angle triangle, I will explain you here. When we are taking right angle triangle in which this is as A, sorry, I am taking here this is as C for understanding purpose, and it is B and it is A. So when we are taking this angle, let it be defined as sin theta sin A. Here A means angle A, this opposite side is BC, and hypotenuse is AC, and adjacent side is AB. So sin will be defined as, can be named as this ratio BP by AP. AP means here I took here this is as P. Okay. In the diagram we will take, in previous diagram we took here P only, no? So BP by AP. It gives us opposite by hypotenuse. So it is defined as sin A or simply sin A. We call it as sin A, and simply we have to write it as sin sin A in those triangles. If the values of angle A is x, for example, here we are taking this angle value is x. Now it should be write it as sin x. It should be write it as x. If you are taking here theta, so here we have to write theta like this. What we are taking in the angle place, that should be comes here. So there is no meaning with the sine without this angle. Without this angle, there is no mean for this trigonometric function. Why? Because we are defined opposite side by using this angle. Hence, we can conclude that the ratio of opposite side of angle, measure of the angle and length of the hypotenuse is constant in all similar right angle triangles. This ratio will be named as sine of that angle. So what is that angle? A. When we observe the ratios, it is also found to be constant. And these are the ratios of the adjacent sides of the angle A and hypotenuse in right angle triangle ABP, ACQ, ADR and AE. So the ratios will be named as cosine A or simply cos A. Here we have to read it as cosine A. Cosine A means, what is the meaning of this one? We already discussed about in the table, that is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. These are always constant for each and every triangle with the lengths of the sides and same angle. The values of angle A is x. Previously we discussed in for sine function. Here also we have to write cos x. So in the place of x we have to take theta means cos theta. If you take alpha means cos alpha. If you take beta means cos beta. In the place of angle A, we have to write any value. For example, I am taking 30 degrees, so cos 30. If you take 60 degrees, so cos 60, like that. Hence, we can also conclude that the ratio of the adjacent side of an angle, measure of the angle and length of the hypotenuse is constant in all similar right angle triangles. This ratio will be named as cosine of that angle. There is no meaning for cosine function, cosine ratio without angle. That's why here we are particularly mentioned angle here. Similarly, the ratio of the opposite side and adjacent side of an angle is constant. It can be named as tangent of that angle. So here we are discussing three trigonometric ratios. One is sine function, sine and cosine. Next one is tangent. Simply tangent should be written as tan theta, tan A or tan X. So simply we have to write it as tan, T-A-N, tan. Actually the name is tangent, but shortcut tan. So tan A. A means what here? Angle. A means what? Angle. You write instead of A, I'm taking theta. So tan theta. Like this. Let define ratios of a right angle triangle. Consider a right angle triangle ABC having right angle at B as shown in the following figure. Then trigonometric ratios of the angle A in right angle triangle ABC are defined as follows. This is a right angle triangle, right angle at B, and A is acute angle. So sine of angle A, it should be written as simply SINA, capital A. Always we have to represent angles with the capital letters. So sine A is equal to length of the side opposite to angle A by length of hypotenuse, which is equal to BC by AC. So A opposite side is BC. So this is opposite side and this is hypotenuse. So that's why we write here BC by AC. Next, cosine of angle A, that should be written as cos A, shortcut. So length of the adjacent side to angle A by length of hypotenuse, which is equal to AB by BC. For this A, this is the adjacent side, we know that. So AB by AC, AB by AC. So here must and should we have to know the angle. So without angle, we can't define the trigonometric ratios. When we are taking C means totally it should be changed. Opposite side should be AB. Adjacent side should be BC. Tangent of angle A. Tan A is equal to length of the side opposite to angle A by length of the side adjacent to angle A. That is BC by AB. So these are the important trigonometric ratios. Basic trigonometric ratios are sin A, cos A, tan A. And their definitions given. There are three more ratios defined in trigonometric ratios which are considered as multiplicative inverse of the above three ratios. That means sin A ka multiplicative inverse is cosec A, cos A multiplicative inverse is sec A, and tan A multiplicative inverse is cot. So here multiplicative inverse of sin A is said to be cosecant A. Cosecant A. This one should be written as cosec A. Cosec. Shortcut. Cosec A is equal to 1 by sin A. Multiplicative inverse means we know that 1 by sin A. Similarly, multiplicative inverse of cos A is secant A. So secant A simply written as sec A. And that of tan A is cotangent A. It should be written as cot A. So sec A is equal to 1 by cos A and cot A is equal to 1 by tan A. Similarly, we have to write sin A is equal to 1 by cosec A, cos A is equal to 1 by sec A, tan A is equal to 1 by cot A. So how can you define cosec in terms of sides? So cosec A is equal to sin A, we know that. So reciprocal of this one, that means cosec A is equal to hypotenuse by opposite side. Just we have to take reciprocals of the sin A function like this. This is numerator and this becomes denominator. So opposite side to angle A or of the angle A becomes denominator and hypotenuse become numerator. This is the cosec A definition with the sides. So sin A is equal to BC by AC, cos A is equal to AB by AC. Reciprocal of this one is nothing but cosec A is equal to AC by BC and sec A is equal to AC by AB and cot A is equal to AB by BC. Reciprocals of sin A is cosec A, cos A is equal to sec A, tan A is equal to cot A. So reciprocals. Now take on homework. Define sine and cosine trigonometric ratios for different vertices, that means different angles. So this is the end of the class. We will meet tomorrow.
Students, I hope you all understood the class. What we discussed today, we discussed about definition of trigonometry, in which sin theta is equal to length of the opposite side to theta by hypotenuse. Next, cos theta is equal length of the side adjacent to theta by hypotenuse. Tan theta is equal length of the side opposite to theta by length of the side adjacent to theta. Next, cosec theta. Cosec theta is equal 1 by sin theta. That means inverse of sin theta. So cosec theta is equal hypotenuse by length of the side opposite to theta. Next, sec theta. Sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. That means inverse of cos theta. So sec theta is equal to hypotenuse by length of the side adjacent to theta. Cot theta is equal 1 by tan theta. That means cot theta is equal length of the side adjacent to theta by length of the side opposite to theta. Now you have to complete your homework. If you have any doubt, ask your friends or teachers. This is the end of the class. Thank you.